Good morning, my dear students. So again, it's a great pleasurable moment because the second class we are going to discuss such a beautiful topic today. So before going to the concerned topic, so the 11th standard students, you must know one thing. So in English class, what the things are going, right? So the previous class we are discussing the question pattern in the public, but in the today we are going to discuss some of the beautiful pattern. So this pattern is entirely differ. At the same time, this pattern is most probably it's very peculiar thing because Tamil medium students, they can easily get full marks in the pattern. Then you just assume yourself, then what about the English medium students? Okay, so before we started the topic today, again the new word today. So are you ready to tell the meaning of the new word today? See, the new word today, ambidexter, ambidexter. So what's the meaning of the word ambidexter? It's a beautiful word in English. So what the meaning of the word, a person who has a great talent and he has used his two hands in order to do something, the great work of it. For example, in a right hand he has written something, the letter, and the left hand he has doing some other works. So with the use of two hands he is doing some a peculiar work. It's an extraordinary behavior like that. So I think you have seen that movie Shivaji. So that movie, the character Rajinikanth has to put in the signature in two hands. So that is called ambidexter. That means the person who is able to do the work with the use of two hands, that is called ambidexter. Okay, today the word is over. Let us go to the topic today. So dear students, I already told you that I gave the instruction in the previous class. What? So when you are teaching this particular pattern, you need a note and pen because you have to get the source of information about the particular topic. This is 5-mark question in the question pattern. So the 5-mark question is very, very, very important thing, this only. Because maximum, most of all the students, they can easily get full marks in the particular, even the last public also. But you have a little concentration in the particular. So some menial things that should not be bothered in public, but those things are very much considerable. So what are the things? First of all, we discuss the concern. See, number one. So what is the topic of this? This is called advertisements, otherwise called application for the post. So otherwise called biodata, resume. So there are so many synonymical meaning of this topic. But apart from that, sir, how we can easily get full marks in the particular question? So this is the major doubt for all the students. So first you listen what I am saying to you. So when we are following these principles in the particular topic, you can easily get full marks. First, you know one thing. Read the questions thoroughly. It may come under 5-mark question, that may come under part number 4, 5-mark questions. Okay, read the question thoroughly because this particular question may ask in two different categories, whether they may ask in the form of letter writing or sometimes they give, it is a kind of advertisement. Have you seen the advertisement in the newspaper, where is the Hindu or Indian Express or Deccan Chronicle or Times of India, even in the Tamil newspaper also? So have you seen the, so what we have seen that in the particular advertisement, they have focused in capital letters what the word wanted. Have you seen it? So before that particular, when you are going through the particular advertisement in the newspaper, what are the things you must give much importance? Number one, what is the post is required? And number two, when the interview is going to be happen, going to be conducted? And the third thing, what is the qualification they are expecting? And fourth, what is the salary? They are mentioned. And final, you must know that which place of it. So these things, you must get the information, right? When you are seeing the advertisement, you have to note all these things. After that, what you are going to do? You are going to apply for the post, right? You are going to apply for the post. Before applying the particular post, you have to take down all the important factors about yourself. So that's what I am telling. In the public examination, they are offering this particular topic for 5 marks. For 5 marks. So what type of marks they used to offer? First of all, in the examiner, they expect the bio data only. But in the particular topic, they are given that two major factors. One thing, application, and second thing, bio data. Sir, can we write only the bio data, sir? Yes, you can write. But what is the use? We are attaching the application with the bio data because in order to show what kind of skills you have, at the same time, sometimes they expect the application. So you better to write the application along with the bio data. This is much better to secure full marks. Okay, let us go to the concern topic today. Right, see, read the question thoroughly. How the questions may be in the question paper. Write an application for the post of personal secretary to the managing director of a company. Include the following details: what they are expecting, educational qualification and experience required for the post. Okay. So, first you noted, what is the job they are used to offer? Which job is asked to be vacant? The post of it, personal secretary. So, you have to apply the concerned job, personal secretary. Then, see what they are expecting, majorly two things. One is educational qualification, and second thing, they need a concerned experience of the concerned subject. So, you are going to apply the particular. First of all, I told you already, you must prepare initially the application, then only you have to prepare the bio data. See how the application form should be prepared. Before that, I just give some memory tips. So these are the things are very capable, very useful to you when you are writing the public examination without committing any mistakes. See, the number one, when you are writing the name, I am telling about your name. When you are writing your name, you shouldn't mention your name, whether it is somewhere, whatever may be the name. So instead of using your name, you must write X. But the X should be capital, not in small letter. So how many X, sir? Minimum or maximum into 4. And then second, instead of writing the name of the place, you better to use Y. That should be also capital. So instead of name, X. Instead of place, Y. And what about the next thing? Qualification. So they must very good concentrate. You need some more concentration when you are writing the qualification, because the qualification is must add to the concerned job. Okay. So whether it is a qualification or MA, that means Master of Arts, and second Master of Commerce, and third Master MBA. It's a, you know that well, it's a business administration. Okay, then next thing, when you are writing the bio data should consist at least 7 datas. Okay, minimum 7 datas, maximum 12 or 13. That must be very important. I already told you that application is very important, but comparing bio data is most important than application. Okay, right. When we are writing the application form, we must be very concentrate, because the application form, that must be very, very, very formal. So you have to use the salutation, yours faithfully, yours sincerely, yours obediently. But bio data, when you are writing all the data about your name, father name or something, right? And then you can use that informal. That is why, instead of using yours faithfully, the salutation, you have to use You better to use signature. So signature is an informal salutation, subscription suffix, and yours faithfully is a formal. Let us, we go to the consent biodata today. So when we are teaching, when we are discussing the consent topic, you must give much importance to all these things, because each and every line is very important, because they can simply decrease your marks in the public valuation. Let us be concentrate. Okay, see, number one, dear students, see, from, so from to, okay, from to the particular thing, see, enclosed my biodata. So from to biodata, okay, enclosed my biodata. So these things completely considered is a form of application. And the next only the biodata. So now we are discussing application, not biodata. Let us see one by one. I already told you that when you are writing your name, you must use X. See, first of all, from address, you must write only this kind of format. You never use it your name, you never mention your name of street, you never mention absolutely the name of location where you are living. See, X for your name, Y for the second category. See, the first line stands for your name, the second line stands for your name of the street or maybe the door number, and the third Y stands for, what is it? It denotes the location or living area, where it is a nomical, something at all. Then, two address. If they are giving the two address in the question paper, you can use it. Otherwise, you can frame the two address as you think, whatever may be the address, but the two address should not in your address. You can write your uncle's home, you can write somewhere else the address if they are not giving in the question paper. Okay, then third. So from address and then to address. So one thing is very, very notable. When you are seeing the question paper, if they are giving instead of the manager, sometimes they used to give in the last 2 years public. Okay, so they used to give care of the Hindu, and the door number, and the location Chennai something. But they never mention the manager. If they are not mentioned the manager, you should not add anything to the concern address too. Could you understand what I am saying? If they are giving the manager, means you can write. If they are not giving the manager, they simply give number 12, Kamaraja Street, Chennai. That means you shouldn't add anything like the manager, like something at all. What is given in the question paper, that's only you can write in that true address. You need not add anything in that address. That's very important thing. Because the true address, the interview, the vacancy, maybe the confidential or that may be in open. If it is confidential, they can give the only the number or something, that official address. Their open interview means they can, you can apply whoever it is. That's the thing. Okay, right. Then the third thing, respected sir. Already sir is respectable thing, you know, but you have to add something. Likewise, good, very good. Likewise here, respected sir. And then you have to write the two divisions. This is called a salutations. So the salutations can be divided into two. One is the subject and second is reference. Subject, see the subject. Which subject, what is the major thing you are going to implement here? Application for the post of, what is the post? Personal secretary. Application for the post of personal secretary, see, regarding, but I used to hear only the short form of regarding, REG, because that should be formal. So see, subject, you should not write the full word subject, no, better to use sub, that means subject. Subject, application for the post of personal secretary regarding, and then second, reference, the short form ref, you should not use the reference, because these are all official, these are all formal salutations. See, ref, So what is the use? What is given the information? What is reference? Where you got the information about the vacancy of personal secretary? That's the main thing. So reference, your advertisement in the Hindu newspaper, the particular date 26/6/2020. That means what? What's the meaning of it? Sir, I had seen your advertisement on 26 in the newspaper Hindu. Then only I came to know about the vacancy of this particular job, personal secretary. So these things called salutations. So from address to address and salutation. Then the fourth thing, see, with. From the particular spot, you know. So from with to the end of the portion, that is called a body of the letter. So the body of the letter can be divided into three categories. Number one, the first paragraph stands for or giving the information where you got the information and which job you are going to apply. Then second stanza, that means second paragraph, what's the qualification you have. At the same time you have to mention what type of qualification as well as your experience in the concerned field. Then third paragraph gives the information, what is it you are giving the assurance to the concerned company. So now we are discussing the first para in where? Body of the letter. So first para, what it denotes? See, with reference to your advertisements in the Hindu, date, the concerned date. Dear student, you must know one thing. The date of 26, it defines when you are seeing this advertisement. Okay, don't forget. So 26 something at all. And then, I would like to apply for the post of personal secretary. So you can write only this line, it's enough. What is it? Once again, with reference to your advertisement in Hindu, date, the concerned date, then I would like to apply for the post of personal secretary. But you need, you must come, you make such a kind of doubt. What is it? Sir, why you should use the symbol of comma in between this sentence? Because with reference to your advertisement, right? This is called phrase, that means incomplete sentence. So I would like to apply for the post is a complete sentence. So that is why we must use the symbol comma in between a phrase and the class. Okay, but this complete sentence is a single sentence. Okay, right. So what we are discussing now, the body of the letter, first paragraph deals about the advertisement and what's the post you are going to apply. Okay, then the second para, see, the second para deals about your qualification, your experience and what's your extracurricular activities, that means extra things, you know. See, in your company it's related to the first paragraph. Then second para, sir, I have completed MBA. This is very important, that's why I underlined it. MBA, there is very suitable qualification to the concerned post, personal secretary. Sir, I have completed MBA with the first class in XYZ University. Sir, can we mention the name of the university? That's no problem. But I just write XYZ. But you shouldn't write YY University or ZZ University, no. Better to use XY University or mention the name of the university. Then, and I have 7 years experience in this field. Here the field refers to personal secretary. Besides means not only that. In addition to that, I have a great knowledge in computer, because basically the two things are most expected things in the interview. Number one, there are good communication skills in English. At the same time, you need more knowledge in computer, because without computer and knowledge of English, we can't survive, you know, well, right? Okay. Then paragraph number three. I already told you what is given the third para. You are giving the assurance to the company. What is the assurance? See, it's a kind of a promise. You are sure your obeisance, right? See, sir, if you offer me a chance, If you offer me a chance, otherwise, if you offer me an opportunity, I will show my entire talents to prove myself. Sir, first you offer a great chance to me because I am ready to prove myself. And I am really hard working for the welfare of this company. So after writing these three paragraphs, you must write thanking you, not thank you. Because thanking you is a formal. Thank you is similar to be, it seems to be informal. So thanking you, comma. Again I may remember you. After completing the application form, you must mention yours faithfully. Why? That should be capital. After writing yours faithfully, and then below only you can put your signature. That means you must mention your name. So instead of using your name, what should write? X. In the parallel left corner, it is similar to be the parallel in the left corner, you must mention the two things, place and date. So instead of writing the place, you must mention why. And the date is very important here. Because when you are seeing the advertisement here, 26, after 2 days, you are going to apply for the post on 28, 6, 2020. Because the interview is going to held in the next week. Like, you must imagine like that. Then I enclosed my bio data. Okay, ma. So arthu parkana. So enclose my bio data. Mudinjavadna. Listen, my students. The final thing. This is a topmost and most important thing comparing all these things. This is the very important comparing all these things. If you are making any mistakes in the particular, the mark will be decreased easily. Comparing this particular, this is most important. Because in the examination in public, the examiner, they can most expect these things only. Comparing that. Okay, so these things are very, very important. Let us be concentrate one by one. So application is over. Now, the bio data has started. So how many data you have to mention? Minimum 7, but I just give more than 7. See, number 1, name. Number 2, father's name. Some students, they have committed some mistakes in father's name. So you must very concentrate when you are writing the particular subtitle. Father, apostrophe S. Father's name. And third thing, date of birth and age. Actually, see, the age is mentioned here. The age is mentioned, you see, the 1994 is the date of birth. Okay. So let us discuss later in the age. Okay. So number 1, name. Number 2, father's name. Number 3, date of birth and age. And number 4, gender. And number 5, marital status. Whether you got married or unmarried. Nationality. And then address. Address, address one, communication address or residential address. Educational qualification, experience, languages known, and extracurricular, and expected salary, and the last thing, reference. So these things are most important. So you better to memory all these things. That's very important. It's very capable to secure full marks. So what you must write for this concerned topic? Name, what I have given the instruction to you already. Instead of writing your name, you must write X. See. And then father name. You can mention your father name. Okay. On date of birth, 3/6/1994. Sir, my date of birth is more than, that means after 2000. But see, you have completed 12th standard. And then you have completed the degree. After that, you have some experience, almost 7 years. So you just assume yourself what is the age at present when you are applying the job. I think this year is very capable to compromise all these things. So 1994. Then what about the age? 94, 2004 and 2020. So almost 26, I think. So I didn't say that exactly. It's a kind of. So 26 is very capable because at the age of 21 or something, you had completed all the basic qualification. And after that, 24 age, at the age of 24. So you can gather some information. So you better to write something, or you better to write only the date of birth. I think it's enough. Not for the age, because they can assume. After that, gender. So male or female. You must write whether you are male, means you must mention only the male or female. But you shouldn't write these two things, because sometimes you simply forget to make it the trick. So you better write. So if I am Karthik, that means you better write male. So no sir, I am Karthika, that means female. The next, marital status, unmarried, and nationality, Indian. Address, YYY, and then again the Y. That means the first Y stands for the name of the street, and second Y stands for the locale of the place. And the next, educational qualification. So what is the educational qualification? We already given for the particular. So MBA. And the next, experience. So how many years you have mentioned the particular thing? See, 7 years, I think. 7 years, I think. And then, 7 years in where? Fatima Garments. Fatima Garments. And the languages known: Tamil, English, and Hindi. And the next thing, extracurriculars, typewriting, and computer. So these things are very important. And the final thing, expected salary. Minimum you have to mention 25,000 per month. And reference is very important thing. What? My previous employer. So these things, I think it's a new thing to all the students. After getting a job, they need some assurance about your character, about your performance. If you are mentioned the concerned reference, they used to ask the concerned people. For example, if you are mentioning someone the doctor name, so they used to contact and to know about your character and talent. So these things are very important. See, the bio data will be started from name and it must be ended reference. So after writing bio data, then you must write declaration. Declaration seems to be the assurance. See, declaration. So what you have written? All the above details are true to my knowledge. Final. It's going to be finished today. So after writing the declaration, again you have to mention thanking you. So I already told you, bio data is similar to be informal. That is why, instead of using yours faithfully, you must write here signature. When you are writing this particular topic, you must put your signature above the signature, not in the below. So signature, and put your signature XXX. Don't make it your signature here in the public examination. You must write only X. In the parallel left corner, place and date. So dear students, so I think you have gathered some information about the biodata. So don't afraid of it. Don't fear about it. It seems to be very lengthy and simple. It's a very simple thing. So I already giving the instruction. Today we have discussed the two things, application and biodata. Biodata is most important than application. So when you are writing in your note, you must give much importance to all these things. After writing these things, you must try to memory this kind of things. See, what are the things I have underlined? So that particular concern area, you have to give much importance to that. So today, I think the class is very useful to you. So if you have some doubts, you can contact the concern number. It is given by the management. So once again, I tell you, take care of yourself. The class is, it's completely outlined form of it in English. Okay. So the next class, we are going to meet some other beautiful topic. So until then, we are thanking you and convey my wishes to all the people. Take care of yourself and take down these things. The topic of this advertisement or letter writing, it must come under 5 mark question. Okay, thank you students, thank you so much.